Hi everyone and welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will be providing interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases. So don't forget to subscribe and follow us to stay up to date. Let's get started. What we have today is an implantation of three implants with three multi-units. Now, in this case, we used V-type multi-units. The V-type multi-unit itself is kind of a small multi-unit, so when you don't have enough mesial-distal space, you can use the V-type multi-unit. You can have enough space because its cones are very small and the diameter of the multi-unit itself is kind of small as well. So you can't make a restoration when you don't have enough space. So in this case, we don't have enough space mesially to the anterior multi-unit from all of the multi-units. So we decided to use the V-type multi-unit. This way, you can have more space for the gingiva between the multi-unit and the adjacent tooth. So what we did, we placed three multi-units. In this case, we didn't do anything, any immediate loading, then the patient was released home. After a couple of months, we took impressions and made a temporary bridge. Now, because we used the V-type multi-unit, we can use a small screw channel. In this case, you have a small screw channel. You have more zirconia, you have more space for the material and for the strength of the crown. Less of a chance that it will break because you have a cantilever. So when the patient chews on this crown, you have some kind of fracture point that will be around this screw channel. So if you have a large screw channel, you had more chances that the teeth would break. When you make a bridge on multi-units and you have three multi-units that are not parallel, it's a little bit better because it's like a tripod. You have, from all the different angles, every implant can compensate for the forces applied on the bridge. Here you can see the temporary bridge in the mouth. You can see we close the screw channel and you can see how relatively small the screw channel itself is relative to the crown. The patient will be with this temporary restoration until the gingiva has healed, and we wanted the gingiva to get the shape of the tooth. This way, we can have some kind of emergence profile, and it will look like the crown is going up from the tooth itself. Thank you, everyone, that joined in to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more, and of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. Thank you, guys, and see you next time.